In this video, I want to show you how to add headings to your prioritization list. Let me show you what I mean. If you're like me, you've got your library, and over here on the right, you have your prioritization list. These are all the books and resources that I've told Logos that, Logos, I want you to use these within the guides and the tools. These are the resources I want to show up first. Well, if you go through your list, if it's like me, you've got 30, maybe 40, maybe more entries. It's all wonderful. It's there for you to use. But wouldn't it be great if while you were in your library and you wanted to add a new resource, you quickly could find which section and that you need to put that resource, maybe a new commentary or a new Bible. Wouldn't it be great if there were sections, heading sections to your prioritization list? I want to show you how to do that in this video. We've got to do a little bit of a workaround through personal books, but I'll show you how it works, and it might help you to utilize the software a little bit better. Logos lets you upload personal books through DocX files, so Word document files, and you can save them in Microsoft Word. You can save them in Google Docs, which is what I've got on the screen here. Really, any word processor, you can save it to a Word file, and it needs to be DocX. So here, create a document and make the title lexicon, and then put a placeholder in it just to say lexicon. Just make those things, two things match in Google Docs. It's going to be different whatever software you use. But in this app, you go to download, and then you're looking for the Microsoft Word option, the .docx file. Hopefully you can see that. You click on it. It's going to download that file. And then what you do is you create as many of those headings as you want for personal books. So I encourage you to make one as a Bible, lexicons, commentaries, dictionaries. And it's very easy to add personal books. You're going to go to your tool section and you're in Logos, and you're going to type in personal books. You're going to open up the utility. And then what you want to do is you want to add those books. So I've already added one that says Bible, but you need to add something when you say add book. I like to give it three dashes so that it's going to stand out, but I just made one for lexicons, so let's do one for lexicons. It'll stand out with the three dashes, lexicon, three dashes. We're going to add a file right here. It's going to ask you find which file that you just made. It's going to say lexicon. I'm going to build that book. Now, Logos is going to put that book, that personal book that we just made, within the library. And as you can see right here, it says updating library catalog, list may be incomplete. It's going to take it a few moments for Logos to have that information within your library, but I've already put one in so I can show you how it works. Right here, I made this one today using the same three dashes on either side of Bibles or Bible. You drag it, you drop it. I've got Bibles at the top of my list, so I use the NASB first, but right there, now I have a heading. It's a placeholder. It's not a true heading, but it is a placeholder. And hopefully in just a minute, the lexicon personal book is going to populate. In fact, let's take this away. Maybe our catalog will quit updating in just a minute. We're thankful for the work that Logos does. And we will see if it comes up. May take it a minute, but that's okay. But as you go through personal books, you can do this. Just open up your personal book tool and create that personal book. And then once it's updated into your library, you find that resource, and then you just drag it and drop it to whatever area that you want. Okay, so here it should be good now. So let's go to the resource that's made today. Let's scroll down, lexicons. And I have a lexicon section. The BDAG is my first lexicon. So what do I want to do? I want to take that personal book, drag it right there. Now I have my lexicons heading. I love that. I'm going to do that for my Bibles, my dictionaries. I've got one for my lexicons, and then my commentaries. So hopefully this is something that you can use as you study God's Word, as you prioritize your list, that'll make your enhancement of Logos 9 much more usable. Until next time, God bless.